Hi everyone. Thank you for your interest in the virtual cell challenge. In this video, we'll go over how to use state, Arc's recent virtual cell model, to enter into the challenge as a reasonably good start as a baseline. My name is Abhi. I'm a machine learning scientist at Arc in the Computational Tech Center, and I'm the lead author on state. It's a wonderful collaboration across many tech centers here. So if you want more information about that model, please refer to the preprint. At a high-level summary, how the model operates is it takes a subsample of cells that we call control cells. These are cells that have no perturbation applied to them. And then the model takes in a perturbation token, and it combines these two and passes it through a transformer neural network. And the goal of that model is to predict the gene expression or the cell state after the perturbation. And so in the virtual cell challenge, we provide control cells, but also cells under many different types of perturbations. And the goal is to be able to predict the effect of unseen perturbations on the cells. So to start, once you are on the notebook, I would recommend connecting to an A100 runtime. I've already run a lot of these cells, but as you go through the notebook, you will first clone the repository. This just gets the repository folder from GitHub. As that's downloading, I'll talk a little bit about the training data setup and the specific task here. So in the state paper, we wanted to focus on context generalization task. What that means is that you have a set of perturbations. In our case, these are CRISPR gene knockdowns and a set of cell lines from potentially varying data sets. So you'll see here, we use some data from the Replogle-Nodig data set and also the competition training data set. The model is trained to predict the effects of these perturbations across the cell lines in the training data. And then the task of the model is to predict the effect of unseen perturbations in the test context. Note that right now, this is the competition validation data set that we've shared of, I think, 50 perturbations. But 1 week before the competition ends, we're going to be putting out a test set of perturbations, and contestants will be finally ranked on how they do on that unseen test set. This is actually a harder task than what we tackled in the state paper. In the state paper, we only looked at context generalization, but we would always see the effects of those perturbations within the data set that we were evaluating on. So imagine if we had several different cell lines from the computation assay for these unseen perturbations. So here we're actually only seeing these perturbations in a different data set, and it's a little bit harder of a transfer learning task. So we're excited to see how users can get around this and improve the methods proposed in state. So next thing, the users will download this exact data set. So they're going to download a bunch of different cells and the gene expression values for those cells under these different perturbation conditions. Here I've already downloaded it and unzipped the data, and you'll find it in this competition support set data. Users can also set their weights and biases entity. This will enable easier tracking of the experiment as they can see loss curves. Next, running this cell will install the state repo. Users are already inside of the folder that's been cloned from GitHub, so it's an easy installation. And in order to run training, users can run this command. I'll break it down a little bit. So state contains two different submodules. One is the embedding model, and this you can use to get the state embedding or a vector representation of a cell. In this notebook, we focus specifically on the transition model. And so this is just the transformer that operates on gene expression values. So it's not looking at the embedding model right now. We do recommend users experiment with the embedding model to see if that can help with the cross data set transfer learning. And so to run the transition model, you would do uv run state tx and then the train command. The way this command is set up is that you can override several of these parameters using Hydra configuration systems. And so these specific values here, so the batch variable, the perturbation column represents in the training data which column is telling you what gene was knocked down. The cell type gives you the cell type information, and within the perturbation column, what is denoting which cell is a control cell. So these are kind of metadata attributes, if you will. We're also featurizing perturbations with an ESM2 representation. This is not something we did in the state paper, but helps a little bit with perturbation generalization in the more challenging transfer learning task of the competition. And so these ESM featurizations are simply the ESM2 model embeddings for different protein coding transcripts and genes, and then averaged for each individual gene. Lastly here, I've set the checkpoint to just every 20 steps. I would probably recommend every 2000 so that you don't run out of storage while running this. And so users will run this. On your first run through, it will ask you to input some weights and biases information, whether you want to make a new account or if you want to use an existing account. I've already run this command, so it's probably not going to come up in the same way here, but you would enter in your selection down here. So my run is already being tracked since I've done that. If you're using an existing account, you can just paste in your API key as well. So I'm not going to let the model train for too long. But this would, for 40,000 steps, probably take around 2 hours on the Colab notebook. Lastly, we can just view what checkpoints are available. So I trained this just for a very small number of steps. And then we would run inference with the train checkpoint on the validation data. The way the inference works is we've set up an AND data file that contains only control cells. And we apply the perturbations in the validation set. These are just a list of genes. And these applied perturbations are then pulled into this output AND data. Here we are calling it prediction.h580. And so I've already run this script. So you'll see in my output, I have a prediction.h580 already. And you'll see that as the output in this infer command. Lastly, we want to use the cell-eval prepare command. The reason for this is if you actually go to the virtual challenge website and you go to the member area, once you click on submit result, the easiest way to upload the file is by using a VCC generated directly by the cell-eval tool. And so you can install Z standard to run cell eval on the Colab notebook. Once you do that, you would just run this cell and it takes the prediction.h580 file that you generated and also a list of the gene names that are the validation support sets. And so note that this will have to be updated when you're training this and submitting for the test set 1 week before the competition ends. What this does is it packs the files into competition/prediction.prep.vcc. You can go ahead and download this file now. And so this downloads it to your local computer from the Colab website. You'll see this is 3.42 gigabytes. Once that's done, you can go here and enter a model name, choose the file once it's been downloaded, and put in an optional summary, and that's it. Then users can submit to the leaderboard and have their entry show up. So we really expect people will have a good time trying to improve on the state method, both with the architecture, with the task, the model loss, and we're really excited to see what people will build. Thanks a lot.